nga ba ang gagawin sa ating TRF Objective 9, prompt number 2? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's me again, Ma'am Shane. And for today's video, ang pag-uusapan natin ay ang Set B o ang Teacher Reflection Form Prompt Number 2 ng Objective 9 o ang Designed, Adopted, and Implemented Teaching Strategies that are Responsive to Learners with Disabilities, Giftedness, and Talents sa ating RPMS School Year 2021 to 2022. Kung bago ka po sa aking YouTube channel, please don't forget to click the subscribe button below and please don't forget to hit the notification bell para palagi kang updated sa aking video. Disclaimer lamang po, lahat ng aking sasabihin ay ayon lamang sa aking natutunan sa Appendix 1A o ang RPMS Tool for Proficient Teachers. So without further ado, let's get started! For this video ay may tatlo po tayong materials na gagamitin. Una ay ang RPMS Tool for Proficient Teachers o ang Appendix 1A. Pangalawa ang Appendix 4C o ang Teacher Reflection Form. And of course, ito pong MOV na gagamitin natin. Okay? So first, tingnan natin itong RPMS Tool for Proficient Teachers. CRATRI, Diversity of Learners, Curriculum and Planning, and Assessment and Reporting. So for Objective 9, Designed, Adopted, and Implemented Teaching Strategies that are Responsive to Learners with Disabilities, Giftedness, and Talents. So ang gagawin po natin ay ang Set B for Prompt Number 2. Okay? So Set B Teacher Reflection Form. Yun po yung gagamitin natin on designing, adapting, and or implementing teaching strategies that are responsive to learners with disabilities, giftedness, and talents, and a certification from the school head that the RITIS classes have no identified learners with disabilities, giftedness, and or talents. So, ibig sabihin, bukod po sa TRF, dapat may certification ka na galing sa iyong school head, katunayan na wala kang identified learners with disabilities, giftedness, and or talents. Okay po? So, ito po ang performance indicator. Makakakuha ka ng 5 or outstanding if demonstrated level 5 as shown in the TRFs. So, ano po yung pagbabasehan nito? Dito po tayo pupunta sa Appendix 4C or ang TRF rubric. Ayan. So, makakakuha ka ng 5 or outstanding for if reflections, annotations, and or outputs given example, lesson plan exceed the expectation of the TRF prompt. They are complete and show comprehensive and in-depth knowledge about the topic question by providing accurate details and some critical inputs or creativity. Very satisfactory naman po or 4 if reflections, annotations, and or outputs given example, lesson plan exceed the expectations of the TRF prompt. They are complete and show comprehensive knowledge about the topic or question by providing accurate details. Satisfactory naman or 3 if reflections, annotations, and or outputs meet the expectations of the TRF prompt. They are complete and show sufficient knowledge about the topic or question. And satisfactory naman po or 2 if reflections, annotations, and or outputs partially meet the expectations of the TRF prompt, they are either complete or incomplete and show limited knowledge about the topic or question. And poor naman or 1 if reflections, annotations, and or outputs do not meet the expectations of the TRF prompt, they are incomplete and totally disconnected from what is asked. So, since wala po talaga akong gifted learners, okay? So, syempre, ang ginawa ko muna is to have a research tungkol sa mga students na gifted, okay po, or talented. So, sinearch ko muna sa Google how to teach gifted and talented students para naman magkameron ako ng idea kung paano ako maglalagay ng annotation sa aking lesson plan. Okay? So, ayan, credits po dito po sa Classful, ayan, 2022. Ayan. So, nag-search ako, nagbasa-basa ako. Ano po? So, nakalagay dito, get to know their intellectual passions. Yan. Encourage them to talk about current events. Give them the freedom to move. Don't forget their non-academic needs. Get gifted children involved in group work. Try not to turn bright students into teachers. Allow them to chat about books with you. Don't force them to listen to things they already know. Find academic resources for them to explore at home. Suggest that they enter competitions. Teach them that less is sometimes more. Don't expect too much of them. Teach the value of taking a break. Connect them with other gifted students. Suggest that they attend local cultural events. Set up a book club. So, we have different strategies para po sa mga gifted students. So, pwede pa po kayong mag-search, okay? Nang gusto niyong basahin. So, another po na pinagbasehan ko po ay itong ano po bang tawag dito? Yan, credits po dito po sa ACSD, yan, from Ami Azam, 2016. 6 Strategies for Challenging Gifted Learners. So, inaral ko din po, binasa ko din po ito. Ano, para naman may pagbabasehan ako. Ayan. So, offer the most difficult first. Ibig sabihin, huwag yung pinakamadali muna, diba? So, pretest for volunteers. Prepare to take it off. Ayan. Speak to students' interests para hindi sila ma-bored. And enable gifted students to work together. So, mapapansin nyo palaging may groupings. Ano po? Plan for tired learning. And ito po yung mga tips. Do's and don'ts of teaching gifted students. Ito po yung talagang natandaan ko. Ano po sa paggawa ng lesson plan? Understand that gifted students, just like all students, come to school to learn and be challenged. Ayan. So, pre-assess your students. Find out their areas of strength as well as those areas you may need to address before students move on. Consider grouping gifted students together for at least part of the school day. Plan for differentiation, consider pre-assessments, extension activities, and compacting the curriculum. Use phrases like, you've shown you don't need more practice or you need more practice instead of words like qualify or eligible when referring to extension work. Encourage high-ability students to take on challenges because they often used to getting good grades. Gifted students may be risk-averse. Offer training in gifted education to all your teachers. At alin naman po yung don't, yung mga dapat nating hindi gawin? Ano po? Confuse high achievers with high ability students. High achievers put in the time and effort to succeed in school. This may not be the case with high ability students. Their gifts may not translate into academic achievement and their behavior can at times appear non-compliant. So assume that all gifted students are the same and that one strategy works for all. Ano? So dapat ano we make sure 'di ba as a teacher na that hindi sila nalaleft behind, okay? Dapat pantay-pantay yung pagtingin natin 'di ba sa mga students. So assume that by making gifted students tutors, you're providing a learning extension. Confuse extension activities with additional work. And refer to alternate work for gifted students as free time. Call it choice time or unfinished work time so students understand that they are required to tackle a task during this time period and so on. Ano? So, madami pa po kayong pwedeng basahin as references nyo po ano sa paggawa ng lesson plan and ganun din po sa annotations. Dahil nga po nabasa ko ito, yan, nabasa ko itong sa do's and don'ts, yan, as a summary po. So, nakalagay dito, understand that gifted students just like all students. Ano, so, kaya yung lesson plan na ginamit ko, syempre lesson plan din para sa mga regular students, yung mga hindi gifted students, okay? Kaya yung lesson plan ko ay talagang simple lang din po at same lang din ang ginamit ko before doon sa mga videos ko po kung mapapansin nyo. So, nagkaiba lamang doon sa annotations. So, punta na po tayo dito. So, ito na po yung teacher reflection form ko. Prompt number 2. Okay? So, nakalagay po dito, reflect on your attainment of the RPMS objective by answering the questions, prompts provided. Use any local or official language that you are comfortable with. Use extra sheets if needed. Please limit your response to 500 words. So, sa prompt number 2 po, ang nakalagay dito, design a lesson plan for the gifted and talented learners based on your idea on how they may be addressed in your class. Your strategies for the gifted and talented learners must be highlighted. Annotated in this form, attach your lesson plan here. So, ang ginawa ko, nilagay ko dito yung lesson plan. Ano po? So, ang topic ko is all about safety procedures to follow in a workplace. So, once again, kaya ito yung lesson plan ko because I am a cookery teacher po. So, ayan. Punta tayo dito. So, idea. Yan, lesson exemplar po ang ginamit ko, yun pa din. So, sa introduction ko po, nagkameron kami ng pretest. Ano po? Students will answer true if the statement is correct and false if the statement is wrong. So, ano po yung annotation ko dito? So, naka-highlight po. Ano po ang nakalagay dito? The teacher conducted a pretest to determine what gifted and talented student in the classroom know about a subject. So, once again, objective 9, focus po tayo sa gifted and talented students. Ano po? Kaya ganito po yung annotation ko. This is to prevent the student who has already mastered the concept sit through the lesson again. So, syempre, kung ang student mo ay alam na, 'di ba, sa pretest we test their prior knowledge. Kung dito pa lang ay almost perfect na nila yung pretest, edi ibig sabihin alam na nila kung ano yung lesson. So para dito dapat meron kang plan B, okay? Para sa next lesson. Yan, para hindi sila paulit-ulit doon sa tinuturo mo. Okay? And then, dito naman sa development, yan, nagkameron kami ng safety first, yan, create a concept map that consists of at least 4 safety workplace procedures in the preparation of appetizers, rather, they will be given 8 minutes to finish the task. So, ang annotation ko po dito, the activity safety first enable gifted and talented learners to work together in groups. It boosts their academic achievement and benefits other students in the classroom as well. When gifted students work together, they challenge themselves in unexpected ways. They bounce ideas of one another and take a peer's idea to a new place. And another annotation ka naman po, for engagement, yan, nagkameron kami ng Makes Me Wonder and No Safety, No Pain na activity. So, ang nakalagay po dito, the teacher posed questions that focus on asking hot questions during Makes Me Wonder and No Safety, No Pain activities. Followed by pushing the student to support their answer. So, kasi ang nakalagay po dito, what is a workplace safety procedure? How will you ensure safety in the workplace? Ito po ay parang fill in the blanks. Some of the personal protective equipment I use in preparation are, if I'm not sure with of how to do a task, I will blank. So, asking gifted and talented learners to dig deeper into the material activates their critical thinking. So, the said activities displayed how gifted and talented learners will apply this learning in a real-life situation, and the teacher let them suggest multiple answers for these questions, scenarios, to encourage students to challenge them to learn about their world in more rich and complex ways. So, last po, ano po, for assimilation, nagkameron ulit kami ng quiz. Yan, kameron kami ng quiz and another is reflection. Yan. So, sa reflection ko po, in the learner's journal, they will give a critical review of the lesson, determining some points regarding good thoughts, what could have been done differently, and other suggestions to make the experience better. So, ang annotation ko po dito ay, the teacher used reflection as a formative assessment for the student to use journals as a self-reflection reflective tool to write their opinions, ideas, and concerns about the class or discuss and analyze subject-related materials. With this, the teacher can use this evidence to help understand what gifted and talented learners know and adjust plans, enriching and accelerating learning as appropriate.
Dito na po natatapos ang ating video. I hope na madami kang natutunan. Kaya naman, if you like this video, don't forget to comment, like, share, subscribe, and click the notification bell for more updates. See you on my next video. God bless!